Is this wrestling? When someone says the word wrestling, people immediately think of the WWE. Matches with predetermined outcomes, filled with soap opera-like storylines. The WWE is purely for entertainment purposes, and most people think it should not be considered wrestling. This is wrestling. A skilled match that battles wit and agility in a man-on-man competition to see who will withstand the attack. The only team is yourself. Do you have enough guts to finish him off? Wrestling is one of the oldest forms of combat, dating back to ancient Greece. In those times, wrestling was considered a divine art and the most important training for young men. Wrestling defined the original Olympic Games as a key event. I recently went to a high school match and talked to assistant coach of the Pope John High School and got his perspective on the sport.
I feel that it's more than just a sport. I feel like people don't understand what wrestling is. I feel it's more of a devotion. You know, it's a diet. You have to train on your own. It's an individual sport. So I feel it's more than a sport.
Wrestling has had its share of controversy in the past years because some wrestlers use extreme measures to lose weight, resulting in serious injuries, eating disorders, and even death.
I don't approve of half the things that these kids are doing, but yet again, I am a witness. I probably would have done some of them too if I was close in weight. Luckily for me, I never cut weight like these kids do. They are up in the morning in trash bags, dropping their water weight, which is very dangerous when it comes to wrestling that same day, or kids taking diet pills. I wouldn't recommend it. A teammate last year in college lose 8 pounds in one day, and he had to wrestle that day, and he got really hurt. He dislocated his shoulder, and I honestly don't know how he lost the 8 pounds, but 8 pounds in one day, that's got to be dangerous.
Dr. Merkel, a pediatrician for over 11 years in New Jersey, shares his experience in dealing with wrestlers.
Well, I think any kind of sport will give you a lot of cardiovascular activity, which is very good. There are some downsides to wrestling. Some children force themselves to lose weight in unhealthy ways. And fortunately, the state has come through with some guidelines about how quickly children can lose weight. And so I think we're on the right track.
Ron Jones is the owner of Drill Masters, a wrestling powerhouse that housed some of New Jersey's best up-and-coming wrestlers. We spoke about some of the issues that existed in the wrestling world.
I came up. Trust me, they issued you rubber suits. They made you feel bad if you didn't cut weight. And I learned the hard way my sophomore year when I cut weight. And then every year I moved up after that, I didn't cut weight. I cut weight, but not as much as that. I learned to condition it off, okay? So I try to get my kids to condition off the weight. And fortunately, wrestling has changed a lot. They do the hydration tests and everything, and it's getting a lot better. The way they change the weight classes up so kids don't cut as much weight, and it's becoming more frowned upon to cut a real lot of weight. So
wrestlers are susceptible to a variety of diseases, ranging from skin infections to permanent limb deformity.
Most commonly, we see fungal infections, which is a ringworm. And sometimes we'll see breaks in the skin, which can then predispose the wrestler to bacterial infections like MRSA, which is methicillin-resistant Staph aureus, and that can be very, very serious. Cauliflower ear is a development of the anatomy of the ear after multiple traumas. Mm-hmm. Wrestlers and boxers get it very frequently because they have many, many blows to the ear.
Little wrestlers are dedicated to perfecting their craft and hope to one day play in the Olympic Games. I got a chance to talk to some wrestlers whose dreams of one day competing at the higher level.
One of my main goals is to wrestle an Olympics and become an Olympic champion.
Of course, that's my dream.
The future of wrestling is in trouble. The International Olympic Committee has voted to eliminate wrestling in the 2020 Olympic Games. The IOC's decision isn't the end. Wrestlers can appeal later in the year. the announcement sent shockwaves through the wrestling world.
How can you get rid of wrestling? It is the oldest sport in existence. In no walk of society can you tell me seniority does not matter. Nothing can date itself back as far as wrestling. They didn't have bikes, they didn't have balls, and they didn't have bats. They were pushing and pulling on one another.
And wrestling doesn't get as much credit as it should be. Like for the Olympics, for example, we're taking it out. As I said before, it's a devotion. It's not a normal sport. Individual. Like boxing, UFC, individual sport.
That situation, Chael, you know, I think about the kids. You know, when you get into basketball, as you're a kid, you say, I want to play in the NBA. When you wrestle, you want to say, I want to wrestle in the Olympics one day. And you know what? That's going to kill a lot of kids' dreams right now.
We had no representation. We had no representation from the United States on the executive committee. How can you vote on a sport that has dominated throughout time in the Olympics? Their medal count has been one of the highest in any sport, and have no representation. The United States of America won the medal count, and there's no representation for our sport, nor for our governing body in a vote. Nor do we have any idea that wrestling is a real threat of being dropped.
My name's Carol Huynh, and I'm a wrestler.
Although wrestling is going to have to fight to stay relevant in a fast-changing environment, the future of the sport demands respect and wants their chance to shine, and they will not be denied.